Hello everyone and welcome to Slim Plus Cuisine. My name is Harper, if did not know, and today I am going to be accepting Hannah's challenge for me to make a layered cake. So I'm going to take some liberties and say that I'll be making a two-tiered layered cake. Very, very simple vanilla or like yellow cake. It's more or less vanilla with chocolate frosting, and it's gonna be great, hopefully. But with that, let us begin. So here are all the ingredients. As you can see, pretty great. Also, there's my dog. He's been barking a little bit lately because he believes that there's an invisible person outside of my house. Here are all the ingredients. And yeah, pretty simple, pretty easy, but watch me mess up accidentally. I hope not, because my friend's coming over actually to eat this with me, so we're gonna hope I actually succeed it. I'm gonna first preheat the oven to 300 degrees Fahrenheit. So yeah, also, this is very dirty. I should probably clean that before I actually film, but it's too late now. Okay, let's continue. First things first is to cream the sugar and the butter together. As you're probably seeing, one piece of butter has been in the fridge for a long time. And you can just guess which one that is. Oh, there we go. Okay, let's begin. Okay, so the butter is more or less cream, so we're gonna slowly start pouring. Oh my God, boots! So we're back finally after a little intermission of my cat trying to lick the cream or the milk, my dog getting chased by the cat. So more or less, next thing is to pour in the sugar and just cream it together until it's nice and smooth and fluffy. This will probably take a long time, so speeding up the footage. Done. This looks really nice. It's nice and fluffy. It looks pretty great. It's probably the best I've done when it comes to creaming sugar and butter together, because I'm not sure, I wasn't as impatient as usually am. So I'm just going to take this out, clean it up, and then continue on. So give me 1 second. So next things next is the eggs, one at a time. So first one in. Occurred to me that I might actually was supposed to do this by hand, but the damage has already been done, so why don't I just prolong the suffering and just continue the maybe bad habit. So let's go on. Add in the vanilla. My cat is on the table. He's looking a little suspicious. Oh, he's getting something he's not supposed to get into. Okay, let's continue on. So I'm gonna say we're done. It looks really good. A little bit like that. We're gonna just, you know, clean these off and then get ready to start making the dry ingredients and then adding everything together. So fun, 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 let us continue on. So now I have a bigger bowl. I'm going to add all the great cream mixture into said bowl. Okay, so now I'll be adding the salt and baking powder, which is in one place, and then the flour, and then we're gonna beat this all together. So give me 1 second. We also have the, we also have the milk right here, so we're gonna also start pouring that in slowly. Okay, let's begin. Kind of just dawned on me that I might have accidentally poured this all too much. You know, people usually say, you know, pour some at a time and all that, and I kind of poured the whole thing in, so oops. Okay, but more or less, let's begin. Okay, so we're done combining everything. It looks really good. I'm actually pretty proud of it. So I'm just going to clean this up and then we'll go to the next step. Everything looks pretty great. I'm pretty proud of it. The texture looks good, I think. So we have these amazingly little pans. Yes, they are, they're quite old, but they are very clean inside. That really matters. This, I cleaned it really well. It was like a rust spot, but it is all clean. No one was gonna die. Hopefully, everyone's gonna continue on. I feel like these are a little bit too small. They are, I think, 9 inches, but they look pretty shallow, especially for all of this cake. And I don't really know how to fix that. I don't really have any other pans that are like these exact sizes. We might be making like a 5-tiered cake at this point. I'm just going to pour and see how it turns out. It's, yeah, I know that you're supposed to like just go to like the middle, because then everything, it'll expand and then blah, blah, you have it figured out. I'm gonna actually look for other cake pans just a second, and then I'm gonna come back to you guys. But if not, we're just gonna use these and we're just gonna make a lot of layers, and then we're just gonna make a lot of a big old layer cake. I don't have pegs, which I know you have to do, you know, when you have like a higher tiered cake. I do watch baking shows, but I don't have those, so we're just gonna figure this out. This might be a ginormous disaster. Okay, we have nothing else, so we're gonna use this and just go on with it. So, halfway. I honestly do have to say that this cake batter, though, though is amazing. I love it. It looks great. It feels great. You know, it feels great as in like it looks great. I am very proud of it. This actually might fit it all. We might actually have a winner. Yeah, I have to say this might actually turn out really nice. I don't wanna, you know, knock on wood kind of thing. Hopefully I just didn't jinx it because that would suck. I think I'm done. You know, bowl is more or less clean. Here are both of the tins. They are both definitely not filled up to halfway there, so they should not overflow. So I'm gonna put these on an oven for 25 minutes and then continue on. Confidence level is pretty high right now. I am feeling really good. So yeah. There we go! They look so good and they smell amazing. They are very uneven if you look at them. Like this one kind of is slanted this way and this one's slanted, well, it just looks weird. So they're not very even, but they look amazing. So I am just going to put a knife through and just like cut around the edges very quickly. And then I'm gonna let them cool off for around 10 minutes before I actually start doing stuff. So yeah, so it's been our 10 minutes. I'll make it very clear right now that I have no idea how to actually get these out of the pans. So I'm just gonna guess and just go on with that. I'm gonna try to do it like the way that you get rid of bread, you know, you're not gonna get rid of bread. And we're just gonna hope this is the right way. So one, two. Please. Ooh, look at that! Oh my god! Okay, so there's a little bit of issues, but it looks so nice. Okay, so it definitely needs to be, you know, cooled off even more just because this is very hot. I don't want the icing to die on it. We're just gonna see if this works out. Please don't break. Please don't break. My hands are clean. Please don't break. Oh, please don't break. Oh, look at that. It didn't break. I'm just gonna see if this works. There, look at that. That was, did I break anything? I didn't. Okay, we're awesome. Okay, so I'm gonna let all this stuff just cool down for like 10 more minutes and then we'll start actually icing this thing. Yes, it's actually working. Oh shoot. Okay, there's a huge issue with the crumbing right here, but after that, looks amazing, smells amazing, and I am so excited. So it has been a couple of minutes, and as you can probably see, the cakes have cooled down a little bit, and now we're gonna start, you know, icing this. Now, I'm gonna be very honest with you. I bought actual, just like, you know, pre-made icing because number one, it said that's how you do it in the directions. Number two, I just don't like to make icing. I don't like making icing. I had a really bad time making it last time. I made a video, AKA cupcake video. So I just don't wanna deal with that. I also say that I am absolutely terrible, like absolutely horrible at icing cakes or icing anything. I'm not good at it. I don't know how to do it really well, and I mess up every single time. So this is gonna be a disaster amount what we do, and we're just gonna hope it doesn't look like a hot mess. So I'm gonna begin by first icing the first layer. My dog has something in his mouth, and I think it's actually something my mom wants to have. Nope, that is a receipt for a bank. Oh my gosh, Sebastian. Okay, he ate like half of it. Chocolate icing. Down. If anybody wants to comment below and like give me some, you know, advice or tips about icing a cake, please do so. I would really appreciate it. I mean, of course I could just, you know, watch a lot of videos and all that, but number one, I'm too lazy. And number two, more importantly, in the interaction, you know, having that support, which would be good for me. But more or less, we're just gonna continue on. Oh gosh, this is gonna look really bad. Oh dear. Oh, it's stuck to the board. That's not good. Oh, come on, please, please, please. Oh, no. Yeah, it's stuck to the board really hard. Okay, so, please say, okay, we got it. So thankfully, all being iced over, so this mess will be done. I'm gonna clean this up and then come back to you guys, so 1 second. And everything looks like it's even, which is actually pretty surprising. It might be a little bit on that side a little too much. Okay, I think everything's right. Okay, so I'm going to start icing it more. Okay, so I'm gonna try to smooth this all out. It's all the way iced through. I am going to try to clean up the sides a little bit, like just the side of the plate, and then put on some strawberries because I want to make it look cute. Okay, so it is done. I realized that this is kind of lopsided. Actually, it really is off center. It's like, this is the center and it's like right there. That's not good. More or less, we're gonna try to cut this, make a little slice for me, and then we're gonna see how it actually tastes. You know, it looks like somebody who just made a cake for the first time in their life, which is what's more or less happened right now. So, you know, it could look better, but at the same time, it could look worse. So, that's gonna be my excuse. And then, go. I mean, it's cooked, but oh, okay. So the bottom of the cake, a lot of this, it got accidentally steamed because it was, you know, because there's like a small divot in this pan, this plate. And so the bottom of the cake, as you can probably see, the steam rose from the cake and then it kind of accidentally softened this area. I was worried that it was undercooked. It wasn't, it was just that situation. Thank goodness. Yeah, everything else looks really good. So yeah. So I'm gonna see how this tastes, and yeah, here is the cake, and let us see how it's turned out. So I'm gonna have this part right here, get a little bit of everything. Oh God, okay, I said that and then it all fell apart. Okay, come on, okay. Okay, so number one, it tastes really good, but there are some issues. Number one, the cake itself, there isn't really any flavor. You know, it's very sweet and it's very buttery and it's very delicious and it's completely cooked through and it's moist, but there isn't really any flavor. You can't really taste the vanilla and it's kind of just like, you know, a buttery sweet cake, which can be very bland if you just have that. So having the chocolate with the cake is a really, really good decision because, you know, the chocolate, it really goes with the kind of blandness of the cake and makes the cake, you know, melt together into this perfect sweet, buttery masterpiece. It's really, really good. And that's really the biggest thing I have to say about this cake. After that, it tastes really good. It's decadent. The only issue is the whole idea of the cake being kind of like you'd say bland, or as bland as a cake can be. And so with the chocolate, everything else tastes really good, but without the chocolate, it probably would taste kind of boring and not very good. So chocolate was a really good idea. I honestly really like it, but it's very rich and it's very intense, and I definitely will not be able to eat this whole cake. So on a scale from 1 to 10 on my rating scale when it comes to making these videos, sorry that my dog was just scratching his neck. 1 being terrible, 10 being yes again and again and again. I would give this a solid 8. Tastes really good, it's really great, but because of the fact that, you know, it looks kind of yikes, which is kind of, you know, my fault, of course, and of course the fact that the cake itself is kind of bland, you know, there's not a lot of flavor when it comes to, you know, vanilla, whatever, I would say solid 8. Really, really good. I really like it. I'm really proud of myself, you know, humble brag, and I'm pretty happy. You know, this is a really, really great experience. You know, I'm coming out of this very, very confident about my baking skills. Not my icing skills, but my baking skills. So if you guys want to make this cake yourselves, I will put the actual recipe that I use in the description down below. So if you want to check it out there. And of course, again, thank you so much, Hannah, for suggesting this video. I really appreciate it. And I have to say, it probably turned out pretty well. So I hope that I conquered this challenge. And with that being said, of course, if you guys want to suggest your own meal or dish that you think I should cook for the first time in my life, just comment below. And of course, if you like this video, just click that like. If you want to see more from moi, just subscribe. I hope you guys had an amazing day. I will see you next time. And as usual, goodbye.